Ladies and gentlemen, Laurie Cardoza-Moore with Proclaiming Justice to the Nations, and it is the eve of Hanukkah. And so I want to just wish all of our friends, Jews and Christians, who celebrate Hanukkah, a Hag Hanukkah Sameach. And as we light the candles of the Hanukkah tonight, and we bring a little bit more light into this dark world, I pray that you all will be blessed with being surrounded by family and friends, and remember that just as God performed the miracle as he did for the Maccabees back several thousand years ago, he can do that for us today as well. But I wanted to bring something to your attention, because talking about darkness in the world, I was sent a video by an elected official, a state elected official in the state of Michigan. And this is State Representative Cynthia Johnson, and I was deeply disturbed by this video. You could probably look it up on YouTube if YouTube hasn't pulled it yet to protect her. But she sent out a warning to Trump supporters, and this is really disturbing because this is what she said. She told them to be careful, and she said, "We ain't playing with you." Then she calls for soldiers of Christ, and she says to those soldiers, "Do it right. Make them pay." Well, ladies and gentlemen, is she threatening the Trump supporters? Is this an elected official who's threatening another person or people group that she might disagree with politically? Is this Nazi Germany? Are we in Russia, where leaders, elected leaders or not elected leaders, can threaten people like this? This is outrageous. But as I was doing some research, another video came up. And I have not really been paying very close attention to the candidates that are running in Georgia until this whole fraud started happening with the ballots and the counting of the ballots in the Dominion. But as I was looking through, I found a video that was equally disturbing by this Reverend Warnock. And again, I've never heard of this guy before, but this is interesting because here's a quote in the video, and you can watch this video. It's down below. Click on the link. You'll get to see it yourself. But this is what he said. "It's been a tough week," he said. "The administration opened up the U.S. Embassy in Jerusalem. Standing there were the president's family and a few mealy-mouthed evangelical preachers who are responsible for the mess that we found ourselves in, both there and here, misquoting and misinterpreting the scriptures, talking about peace." Well, I have a question to Reverend Warnock. If we mealy-mouthed evangelical preachers or leaders are misquoting or misinterpreting the scriptures, could you please give us some examples of what we're misquoting or misinterpreting? Because you know what, Reverend Warnock, I don't know where you got your degree in theology, but I've read the Bible and I've studied it from beginning to end. And that book is a book written to Israel, for Israel, and about Israel. And let me also tell you, Reverend Warnock, that as Christians, we are grafted into the Commonwealth of Israel because of our faith in Christ. And I don't know what Christ you follow or who you're worshiping, but it doesn't sound like the same one that I know, because God made a covenant to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob and their descendants, which Jesus happens to be a descendant of. He is a Jew. But I don't know what you don't understand about the covenant God made with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the eternal covenant, that he would be a God to them forever, that he would make Israel and their descendants like the stars of the heavens and the sands on the seashore, and all the land he was giving to Israel, he's giving it to them forever. It doesn't end. But Reverend Warnock goes on a trip, a pilgrimage, with another fraudulent Christian group called the National Council of Churches, who are chummy chummy at the United Nations. And of course, this group who went on this pilgrimage also had their own opinion about the poor Palestinian people. And he's bought into the lie that the Palestinians are being persecuted by the Jewish leader, by the Israeli government. And he even talks about Bethlehem, that the Palestinians are persecuted in Bethlehem. Well, ladies and gentlemen, and Reverend Warnock, we actually did a documentary called Boycott This. You can get it on the website, and you can watch it. You can even watch Boycott This on Amazon Prime, because it's right there for free to watch. Maybe, Reverend Warnock, you should tune in and watch it, because it just so happens that those Christians in Bethlehem, the Palestinian Christians that you talk about who are being persecuted, yeah, they were being persecuted in Bethlehem, but it wasn't by the Israelis and it wasn't by the IDF soldiers. It was at the hands of the Palestinian Authority, because they would not follow what the Palestinian Authority wanted from them. They were persecuted, and now 80%+ of those real Christians fled Bethlehem because of the Palestinian Authority. And, you know, also in that documentary, Reverend Warnock, you could look at the city of Nazareth, because we did a great segment on the tale of two cities, Bethlehem and Nazareth. And in Nazareth, there are Jews, Muslims, and Christians who all live together in Nazareth. Christians there aren't being persecuted by the Israeli government. You know why? Because the Israeli government actually protects them, because the Israeli government governs over Nazareth. The Israeli government doesn't govern over Bethlehem. That is the Palestinian Authority. So, Reverend Warnock, you've obviously been deceived. You bought the anti-Semitic lie about Israel and the Jews, and you falsely accuse those of us evangelical Christian leaders and pastors who cite the scriptures, not man's doctrine and not man's theology, whatever that is. So, ladies and gentlemen, we need to be very careful about who we listen to, and these leaders should be called out, because God made every one of us in his image, and he has a plan for every one of us, and that plan is to be blessed by Israel, not to condemn and not to curse Israel like Reverend Warnock is doing here. So I want to thank all of you, all of our PJTN watchmen, and I want to thank those of you who have answered the call to our year-end fundraising plea to help us finish this year strong. We could not do what we do without you. And so I just want to wish you all a very happy, again, Hanukkah, and God bless you all, and thank you so much for all you do on behalf of our Jewish brethren, the State of Israel, and the United States of America.